we're gonna hit it really hard today. We have to. We have to. And fortunately, we're able to. Maybe not. Let's see. An old friend just called in. I haven't heard from him quite some time. He's struggling. All over the world, I think, people are struggling. He's in another country. And everyone's being undercut by super cheap labor. And it's a global problem, really. People who do it the right way are being undercut. Now, I said we're going to hit it hard here. Let's see if I can get back to focus. Now, last night, I can call it the inner teacher. I was aware of the inner teacher. The inner teacher was talking with me very directly and clearly. The inner guru, I guess you could call it. No form to the guru. I can't say, oh, it's Jesus or this. No, it's just the inner guru. Maybe it's the Holy Spirit, you can say. And pragmatically speaking with me about something. About the future, okay? Because the last video I did was about the future, not valuing the future. And what it said was that there are those who are ready to go to take the next step. So we will take the next step here. And it's a practice that you would not expect to use at all. This is the problem, isn't it? Is the steps we need to take, at first they seem like crazy. Say, wait a minute, this is counterintuitive. It's not really. And so if you get into it, you will understand this for a moment. Now keep in mind that the day can be disjointed, all right? Various things, calls come in, people, this, that. Fine. Now, you stay right on track. This inner teacher showed me something. I want to use an analogy. They used an analogy to me. I saw someone riding a bike, and you know how you're riding a bike and you start slowing down and you slow down more and more and you're talking to someone, maybe they're walking or they're stopping you, and as you slow the bike down, it starts to get real wobbly, right? When the bike's going quick, it's easy, smooth, you know, but you slow way down, very wobbly. And you think, whoa, I'm gonna fall. Can't keep your balance when the bike is not moving, right? And so this teacher said, this teaching here is for those who have slowed the bike down, the wobbly, it's very wobbly, it's very wobbly bikes. And I said, what about me? I'm not even on a bike. They said, even better. So you don't even have to worry. The bike slows you down too much. Okay, so that's even better. So it's for those two. There's those two types of people that this teaching is for, I was told. Those whose bike has been slowed down really, really far, and those who have gotten off the bike. Okay. What is the bike? It's the bike of duality. It's the bike of relativity. It's the bike of the two wheels. The two wheels symbolize the relativity and the duality, the dualistic mindset. What is the attempt to stay on the bike? That's the ego. The ego wants to stay on the bike. We actually have to set the bike down gracefully. Just instead of trying to stay on the bike, when you decide to get off the bike, just put your foot on the ground and set the bike down, and there's no more imbalance problem. There's no more imbalance problem. So, how do we set the bike down? How do we get our foot on the ground? Okay. These are the practices that we must use. Out of 100 serious spiritual pilgrims, maybe one will actually start practicing something. The rest will keep on trying to stay on that bike. I need to speed the bike up or feeling wobbly. Now, feeling wobbly is good. It means you're slowing the bike down. Feeling a little bit this instability, like, whoa, it's very wobbly, what's going on? It's because the bike of duality has slowed down. Duality is completely referential as far as you have a it's a, all illusion, and it's a battle of illusions. Which illusion is going to triumph, for instance, or which illusion is best? And we say, well, this, which illusion is in the best location? Which illusion is most likely to be true? Or which lie is most likely to be true? It's judgment between all these illusions. And so as you slow that all down, you might feel wobbly because you think, wow, I don't think I'm able to discover which is lie is true. That's right. You can't discover which lie is true. You cannot discover which lie is true. You cannot discover a location where pure consciousness is crystallized. You cannot discover such a location. So we're riding our bike around trying to discover. And the practice is, I cannot discover. Truth is not discoverable. Truth is not discoverable. God is not discoverable. I cannot discover God. This is a good way to start, and it's a shocker. But who is the I? It's the search. It's the personality. It's the ego. Personality, the ego is searching for God. Well, is God an island to be discovered? Is everywhereness an island? And we're sailing in from somewhere else, we're riding in. Say, I discovered everywhereness. There it is. No, it's non-discoverable. Truth is non-discoverable. God is non-discoverable, can never be found, can never be discovered. So here is the parting of the ways of practice. If we can practice this, it is the game changer. It is setting down that bicycle of duality, and we won't feel wobbly anymore. When we're on the ground walking, as it were, we're not worried about the bicycle. We don't have to go fast. We don't have to discover anything. This day, just as it is non-discoverable. I cannot discover it. I cannot discover this day. This day as it is totally non-discoverable. I cannot discover the future. The future as it is completely non-discoverable. Cannot be discovered. Future as it is can never be discovered. I cannot discover this moment. This moment as it is can never be discovered. I cannot discover this table. This table as it is can never be discovered. I cannot discover this wall. This wall, as it is, can never be discovered. I can never discover this rain. This rain, as it is, can never be discovered. I cannot discover myself. Myself, as it is, can never be discovered. I am the undiscoverable self. This moment is the undiscoverable moment. I will never find what I'm searching for. I will never find what I'm searching for. I will never find this table. This table as it is, I will never find this table. I will never find this walkway. I will never find this wall. I will never find this sky. I will never find this day. I will never find the future. I will never find the future. The future is totally, can never be discovered. So this is the basic practice, just introducing this now. And it seems opposite, right? Because the ego, we're trying to discover truth. That's the whole problem. The whole problem is I am trying to discover something. Well, where is I? Outside of truth? I am trying to discover the everywhereness. How can there be some I that is outside of everywhereness that needs to discover, that can discover it? It comes in from somewhere else and says, finally, there it is, I see it, I've discovered it. I can never see everywhereness. I can never see this table. I can never see this walkway. I can never see this wall. I can never see this day. I can never see the future. I can never see God. This is the knockout, a knockout step for the ego, for the I. The one on the bicycle trying to ride is the I. It's He's trying to go somewhere to discover within the context of duality. I and what is discovered. That's duality. God is not discoverable. Truth is not discoverable. Now is not discoverable. How can now be discoverable? By time. Time is discovered now. So, the right practice is this amazing practice of sitting down the bicycle. I cannot discover now. Now is undiscoverable. Truth is undiscoverable. I cannot discover truth. Now is undiscoverable. Undiscoverable. Now cannot, I cannot discover now. I can never discover now. Peace is undiscoverable. I can never discover peace. I can never find it. Peace is unfindable. I can never find peace. And by doing these exercises, you realize you don't need the bicycle. You're off of it. You're off of it. And then there's no more instability. The instability we feel is when we slow down the search. Then everything seems unstable because you think, uh-oh, I'm gonna fall. I can't find it. If I fall, I won't be able to find it. Well, here, we're co-opting that whole step and saying, great, it can't be found. There's no problem. What is everywhere cannot be found, can never be found. And all truth is everywhere, is omnipresent. Omnipresence is omnipresent. It cannot be found. It cannot be discovered. I can never discover what I am. What I am is undiscoverable. So this is the great, great leap in practice here. It takes things to a further extent here of actually getting into real stability. And you say, I can never find stability. Say, I can never find stability. Stability is unfindable. I'll never be able to find it. I, duality, will never be able to find stability. Because how can there be pure stability when there's some I that is finding it? To find means it's lost right now. Truth can never be lost. Well, what can it be lost to? To itself? Is it ever lost to itself? It's everywhere. So how can it be lost? Cannot be lost. If it's not, cannot be lost, it can't be found. Never find God. I can never find God. God is unfindable. God will never be found. God will never be found. Truth will never be found. Peace will never be found. Bliss will never be found. I can never find bliss. I can never find peace. I can never find tranquility. I can never find oneness. I can never find serenity. I can never find grace. I can never find reality. I can never find formlessness. I can never find timelessness. I can never find God. I can never find the all good. I can never find the all abiding. I can never find the omnipresent. I can never find the everywhereness. I can never find it. I can never find it. So, I have faith in this practice because this inner teacher pointed this out to me. It's while I was in sleeping, I remembered it when I woke up. So I can never find truth. I can never find stability. Stability can never be found. Stability can never be found. How can you find stability on a bicycle? True stability. You have to keep moving. You have to keep moving, right? You have to keep going. You're still feeling the fear of stability. Say, I've got to keep going, gotta keep going, otherwise I'll feel unstable. Is that true stability? No. True stability is where there's no fear. Effortless. I can never find effortlessness. I can never discover effortlessness. Effortlessness can never be discovered. You're riding a bike through the land of effortlessness and you're putting all this effort to keep your bike going. Yeah. Wow. I found effortlessness. No, I did not. It cannot be found. It cannot be found. The finder is the bike of duality, trying to find it. It cannot be found. Set the bike down. It can never be discovered. I can never discover anything. I can never discover anything. I can never find anything. I cannot discover this plant. I can never find this plant. I can never find anything. I cannot discover this walkway. I cannot find this walkway. I can never find anything. Once we get on the bike of duality, at first we feel really wobbly. It's, oh my gosh, what do I do, what do I do? And then we start pedaling real fast. That's effort. You see everybody in the world, all this effort, 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 effort. They're on this bicycle, duality. And they don't realize they can slow it down and get off of it. They think, no, I'll get all wobbly and unstable. That is what right spiritual effort does. Right spiritual practice. We get to this point where we're starting to slow it down, feel wobbly, and then we realize, I can just put my foot on the ground. It's like put one foot on the ground, and where's the wobbliness of the bicycle then? The idea that we cannot put our foot on the ground is delusion. Of course we can. But the ego tells us, no, I haven't found what I'm looking for yet. And I still haven't found what I'm looking for, right? You'll never find what you're looking for. I will never find what I'm looking for, okay? I will never find what I'm looking for. I will never find what I'm looking for. I can never find anything. I will never find what I'm looking for. I can't find anything. I have a little concert going on here. The Dream is supplying it. A few drops of water here in California today. A few drops, that's about it. Enough to make the car look even dirtier than it is. I will never find what I'm looking for. I can't find anything. I will never find anything. I will never find anything. But we say that in a happy, grateful way, like, wow, we're finally getting off the bike of duality, relativity. Relative thinking. I found something bigger than something before. It's bigger, so I found it. Now I found it. No, you just found something that's relatively bigger than something else. It's all relative. Relative thinking. Relative thinking is duality. The non-relativeness is what we call enlightenment. I cannot find enlightenment. I cannot find it. Enlightenment can never be found. Now you hear this in talks that people give, but one out of 100 maybe will start practicing. That's the one that gets off the relativity of the relative thinking of the bicycle. That is, the bicycle is wobbly. Instead of what happens is when the bike gets, you slow down, the bike gets real wobbly, and then we start speeding up again. Say, whoa, that's scary, I gotta speed up. And they say, ah, that's better, now I feel better, I'm speeding up again. It doesn't work. So when the bike gets wobbly, that's when right spiritual practice comes in. And you, it's amazing because you embrace it. You embrace it, I can't find it. Instead of the fear entering and say, oh my God, I can't find it, I'm gonna crash, this is terrible, I'll never find it, ah. You turn it around and say, no. I can never find it. I will never find what I'm looking for. You say it as a positive thing. This is not like a mournful practice. Practice is always poised in the mood of repentance and understanding I have a continuity problem. And it's a positive thing, saying, yes, great. I can never find it. I can never find what I'm looking for. I will never find anything. I can't find this day. I will never find this day. I will never find what I'm looking for. I cannot find enlightenment. Enlightenment can never be found. I will never find what I'm looking for. Looking for. Looking. Who's looking? Is omnipresence found by looking? Or by accepting? Or through vision? The vision of acceptance. The vision of acceptance that it can't be found. When we accept that truth and reality can't be found, there it is. When we give up the effort to find it, there it is. Because finding it means it's not here now. If it was here now, if we saw that it was here now, why would we need to find it, try to find it? So the very effort to find enlightenment is the premise that it's missing. It's missing from right now. So, by saying, I cannot find it, whereas base the premise is, it's not missing that, it's not missing from now, it's not missing from now. So don't try to find it now, because there again, you're still saying it's missing. So, I cannot find what I'm looking for. I cannot find enlightenment. I cannot find now. I will never be able to find now. I can never find now. I can never find enlightenment. I will never find enlightenment. I will never find realization. I will never find myself. Myself is unfindable. I will never find enlightenment. Enlightenment is unfindable. I will never find peace. Peace is unfindable. I will never find bliss. Bliss is unfindable. Never find what I'm looking for. What I'm looking for is unfindable. So our only trouble is this sense of instability as we slow the search down. As the search gets slowed way down, we suddenly feel like we're going to crash. Now, the problem with the world is the ego says, yeah, you're going to crash. And so we need to work on this crash. The ego sees this crash as slowing down and says, okay, there's going to be a terrible crash. So we need to model this crash so that we can work on it. We can work on it. It's completely opposite what you're supposed to do. So the future has got all these problems because the ego models, misinterprets, and models. So, something like when you slow down and we think, oh, I might crash. The Holy Spirit says, just put your foot on the ground, set the bike down, no crash, you see. The ego says, oh my gosh, no, you have to find what you're searching for. But first you got to go through this crash. And then you got to learn to deal with the crash. And then you'll find what you're looking for. So it brings about troubles in our lives and collectively. And it thinks it's helping us because it's showing us what our problem is so we can work on it. I can never discover my problem. I can never find my problem. I will never be able to find my problem, so I can never work on it. See, I can never find my problem, so I can never work on it. I can't find my problem. I can't find anything. So the Holy Spirit's practices, these spiritual practices, co-opt the egos entirely. It's a completely different way of looking at it. We turn the tables on the ego. There's not going to be any crash because I'm putting my foot down, right? Putting my foot down is another way of putting it, right? I mean, I'm taking a stand. I take a stand that I don't need to find anything. Nothing is findable. Nothing is findable. Everywhereness is not findable. There is nothing to find. I can never find anything. Then you don't need the bicycle to go around looking, searching. You don't need it. You don't need the search. The bicycle is the mentality of duality. Whereas the ego says that the search has to be successful, but it sees that at some point you're going to have a crash, and then you need to pick yourself up from the crash and get searching even more. So it brings about this crash in the world. And it tells you this is a learning lesson. This is a great lesson for you to learn. No, it's not. We don't need any crash. We can put our foot down and say, no. I don't need to find anything. I can't find anything, and I don't need to find anything. I can't find enlightenment. I don't need enlightenment. I don't need enlightenment. I can't find it. I don't need it. Because the I is the searcher. The searcher doesn't need anything. We're going to let go of the searcher, the search and the searcher. The search implies there's a searcher. Actually, there is no searcher. There's only a search. And the search is supposed to be succeed. And when it succeeds, then we'll realize the I. That there's an I there that was searching. There is no I. There actually is no person searching. There's only a search. We assume that a successful search will complete the new self. That the self is waiting to be born, like this gestation. And it's waiting to be born. And when we succeed in finding enlightenment, that will give birth to this new self. There is no new self waiting to be born. There is no I. There is no searcher. There's only the search to find what cannot be found, what can never be found. So when we see this bicycle, we're only imagining there's somebody riding it. We think we see there's a body there. But there's no I in the body. There's no self to the body, actually. There's really nobody on the bike. That's why you can gently set the bike down. The real self is already on the ground, standing on the ground, as it were, already grounded in everywhereness. They just need to be able to set this bike down and say, oh, okay, there was never anybody on the bike. it was a riderless bike. Thinking that it was searching. There was a search. I needed to find something. I needed to find where I am. I can never find where I am. Where I am is unfindable. Speaking of the real I, the real identity, the one shared identity, the one identity. Shared implies some activity, but it's not. There's not even no activity of sharing it. It's the one identity of all. I can never find my identity. My identity is unfindable. I can never find my identity. My identity is unfindable. So all these riderless bikes in the world, we all say, oh, we got to keep these bikes going, otherwise it'll crash and the eye will die. This idea of it slows down too much, whoa, the eye's going to die, we were told. So we mock up this crash, presumed crash, where the bike slows down and falls over, and we mock it up, and then we work on getting it going again. You know, so we have these cycles. Existence is cyclic. Interesting, cyclic, right? Bicyclic. It's cyclic. And we don't need any of that. See, we know there's no one on the bike. So we can grab the bike, steady it, gently set it down, and no crash. It's amazing what our beliefs and imagination can conjure up. But I don't have to find the truth. I cannot find the truth. The truth is unfindable. I don't need to find the truth. I don't need to find anything. Everything doesn't need to be found. There is nothing that needs to be found. There is nothing that needs to be discovered. Truth is undiscoverable. There is no path to truth. I don't need any path to truth. I don't need to discover truth. Truth does not need to be discovered. Reality does not need to be discovered. God does not need to be discovered. There's no need to discover God. There's no need to discover truth. No need to discover reality. No need to discover divinity. Divinity does not need to be discovered. I can never discover divinity. There is no need to discover divinity. I will never discover divinity. I don't need to discover divinity. Divinity doesn't need to be discovered. I don't need to discover truth. Truth doesn't need to be discovered. Truth is true. I don't need to discover bliss. Bliss doesn't need to be discovered. Bliss is bliss. Bliss as it is bliss. Stillness. I don't need to discover stillness. Stillness as it is stillness. Stillness doesn't need to be discovered. I don't need to discover the all good. The all good as it is the all good. The all good doesn't need to be discovered. I don't need to discover God. God as it is God. God doesn't need to be discovered. I don't need to discover identity. Identity as it is identity. Identity doesn't need to be discovered. I don't need to discover everywhereness. Everywhereness as it is everywhereness. Everywhereness doesn't need to be discovered. I don't need to discover peace. Peace, as it is peace. Peace doesn't need to be discovered. I don't need to discover timelessness. Timelessness as it is timelessness. Timelessness does not need to be discovered. I don't need to discover formlessness. Formlessness as it is formlessness. Formlessness doesn't need to be discovered. I don't need to discover oneness. Oneness as it is oneness. Oneness doesn't need to be discovered. I don't need to discover pure spaciousness. Pure spaciousness as it is pure spaciousness. Pure spaciousness doesn't need to be discovered. So this is a very advanced practice. If you can do it, congratulations. You're very advanced then. If you're able to do this, that means that you're either, you know, off the bicycle and setting it down are at the wobbly point where it's slowed down, and you say, wait a minute, I need to, you know, you're ready to be able to set it down. This is the type of practice from the inner voice of truth that spoke to me this morning, straight onto YouTube for you to consider. This is pretty cool, actually. Yeah, it's, think about it. This is the right use of technology. Somebody gets this practice somewhere in the world, the inner teacher, the inner grace of God, the Holy Spirit, speaks and clarifies and says, do this practice, focus on this today. It's put onto video up to YouTube, and the whole world has access to it that very day. So this is very helpful, actually. I don't think we realize how amazing, how great it is, actually. Yeah, it's just super fast, right? And it's there. Of course, the inner teacher can speak to all of us. It's all of us. The ability to listen, I don't know, this is unusual for me. It's not often that something like this occurs. Does the inner voice have a gender? No, it doesn't. It doesn't. The funny thing is, dualistically, I say, well, is this a male talking to me? Male? No. So I automatically assume it must be a female. See, there's an automatic assumption. That's dualistic thinking. If it's not this, it must be this. Neither. It's neither. It's neither. It's just pure pragmatism. Was the voice of pure pragmatism male or female? No, neither. Neither. More like a friend. As Jesus always says, I walk beside you as a friend. I walk not in front of you, not behind you, beside you as a friend. Same thing with Sri Anandamayi says, I don't want you to look at me as a mother or a goddess or a mother or anything like that. I want you to look at me as a friend or a little child, a little daughter. If you look at me as in a family context, as a little child tottering along beside you, or better, she says, as a friend walking beside you. That is the proper context of the inner teachings. It's a friend that is beside us, not above us, not below us, right beside us. And it's pure pragmatism. Our friend is pure pragmatism. Look at it that way. Genderless, pure pragmatism. That's just one quality. It doesn't have all these qualities. It's pure pragmatism. And it could never be found. It cannot be found. It is. What is, is. What is. What is can never be found. I can never find isness. I can never find, I will never find isness. I will never find isness. Isness as it is isness. Isness doesn't need to be found. Isness doesn't need to be found. I will never find myself. Myself as it is myself. Myself doesn't need to be found. The one self, myself, same thing. I will never find what I'm looking for. What I'm looking for as it is what I'm looking for. What I'm looking for doesn't need to be found. So this is the format. That inner teacher, pure pragmatism, the voice of reason, the Holy Spirit, I guess it could speak to me because it could see I could turn this into a practice for you. compose it into an actual practice here, which is what is actually helpful. Without practicing it, you're not going to get the feel of it. You know, just discursive talk is not enough. It's not enough. It's sort of an introductory step. It's kind of like you're opening a door and you're looking, you know, the door's open, but you got to go inside the room. So practicing is going inside the room. It's just stepping over the threshold is the only difficult point. You can say, okay, I'm going to do it. And you think, oh, the whole world's going to fall apart. No, it doesn't fall apart at all. I can't find myself. I'll never be able to find myself. Myself, as it is myself. Myself doesn't need to be found. So you think, oh, I'm going to go crazy. I say, I can't find myself. No, because you're doing a spiritual practice. There's a format to it. And so you have that. You have that. That's your centeredness. That's your stability. We have this. The spiral is very important. Laying that bike, setting it down, you need a sense of stability. Where's that stability come from? Right spiritual practice. You say, I can do that. See, that's something I can do.
Got the cat here. I hope it doesn't get feisty on me. They start snagging things.
Okay. See, I'm in the cat seat right now. I'm in the catbird seat, you might say. And it's waiting for me to leave. So I say, when are you going to leave? You know, this is its hangout. Its morning hangout is here. You know, it just hangs out and just aware of all the sounds and stuff that happens. It really enjoys that. So it's kind of wanting me to leave. I will never find what I'm looking for. What I'm looking for as it is what I'm looking for. What I'm looking for doesn't need to be found. I will never find God. See, this is the amazing practice. It gets us off this bicycle. It gets us realizing we're not on the bicycle. And we can set it down gently. Set it down gently. Because we're centered in this practice. Who in the world will say, I will never find God? That seems to be the most iconoclastic thing in the world to say, right? But here we rise as the opposite. I will never find God. I will never find God. God as it is God. God as it is God. God doesn't need to be found. See, it's this three-part practice here. Very simple. I will never find enlightenment. You see, the ordinary person listening to this will say, you know, they're crazy. They're practicing saying, I will never find enlightenment. These people are on the wrong path. But it's a three-part practice. I will never find enlightenment. Enlightenment as it is. This instant, right now, as it is, enlightenment as it is enlightenment. It's not something else. It's not coming to enlightenment. It's not discovering enlightenment. It's not finding enlightenment. Enlightenment as it is enlightenment. Enlightenment doesn't need to be found. It already is what it is. It doesn't need to be found. So I will never find enlightenment. Enlightenment as it is enlightenment. Enlightenment doesn't need to be found. And you can use different adjectives, like you say, I will never discover enlightenment. Enlightenment as it is enlightenment. Enlightenment doesn't need to be discovered. It doesn't need to be discovered. I will never realize enlightenment. I will never realize enlightenment. Enlightenment as it is enlightenment. Enlightenment doesn't need to be realized. I will never realize God. God as it is God. God doesn't need to be realized. I don't want the cat sliding off the sofa, because that's when it snags me. He says, oh, I'm sliding off, and grabs. So we set the bike down gently, see? We don't let the bike crash, and because it's going to flail, grab a hold and snag us. So what we're doing now is we're grabbing hold of the bike and then setting it down gently. See, this is how you do it. This is how you do it. There is no rider on the bike. We don't need a rider on the bike. We don't need an eye to find something. See, we don't need to find anything. I will never realize peace. I will never realize peace. Peace as it is peace. Peace doesn't need to be realized. Hello, peace doesn't need to be realized. So these are very, very helpful. I may go get a list, and I'll go down the list for you. So if you have the patience, we will go over some of these terms. It's the same practice, but it helps reinforce. Rather than using the same term over and over again, we use different terms for the absolute. And we can start out with say, I will never find the absolute. The absolute as it is the absolute. The absolute doesn't need to be found. I will never find glory. I will never find glory. Glory as it is glory. Glory doesn't need to be found. I will never find smoothness, pure smoothness. I will never find it. I will never find pure smoothness. Pure smoothness as it is pure smoothness. Pure smoothness doesn't need to be found. I will never find clarity. Clarity as it is clarity. Clarity doesn't need to be found. I will never be able to discover freshness. Freshness as it is freshness. Freshness doesn't need to be discovered. I will never find eternal life. I will never find eternal life. Eternal life as it is eternal life. Eternal life doesn't need to be found. I will never ever find holiness. Holiness as it is holiness. Holiness doesn't need to be found. I will never discover vision. I will never discover vision. Vision as it is vision. Vision doesn't need to be discovered. I will never find freedom. I will never find freedom. Freedom as it is freedom. Freedom doesn't need to be found. I will never find love. I will never find love. I will never find love. Love as it is love. Love as it is love. Love doesn't need to be found. I will never, ever come across purity. I will never come across it. I will never come across purity. Purity as it is purity. Purity doesn't ever need to be come across. Come upon. It doesn't need to be come upon. Silence. I will never ever find silence. I will never ever find silence. Silence as it is silence. Silence doesn't need to be found. Light I will never, ever find the light. I will never find the light. I will never find it. The light, as it is the light. The light doesn't need to be found. I will never, ever find divinity. Divinity, as it is divinity. Divinity doesn't need to be found. I will never find centeredness. Centeredness, as it is centeredness. Centeredness doesn't need to be found. I will never, ever find presence, true presence. I will never, ever find true presence. True presence is, as it is true presence. True presence, as it is true presence. True presence doesn't need to be found. I will never discover beauty. Beauty, as it is beauty. Beauty doesn't need to be discovered. Doesn't need to be discovered. I can never find everywhereness. I can never find everywhereness. Everywhereness, as it is everywhereness. Everywhereness doesn't need to be found. I can never discover sweetness. I can never discover sweetness. But sweetness, as it is sweetness. Sweetness doesn't need to be discovered. I will never find agelessness. I will never find agelessness. But agelessness, as it is agelessness. Agelessness doesn't need to be found. I will never discover compassion. I will never discover compassion. Compassion, as it is compassion. Compassion doesn't need to be found. I will never find certainty. I will never find certainty. Certainty, as it is certainty. Certainty, as it is certainty. Certainty doesn't need to be found. I will never find authenticity. I will never find authenticity. Authenticity, as it is authenticity. Authenticity never needs to be found. Okay, so those are some practices to get you going. Simplicity. I will never find simplicity. I will never find simplicity. Simplicity, as it is, right now, simplicity as it is simplicity. Simplicity is simplicity. Simplicity doesn't ever need to be found. It doesn't need to be found. I will never find relaxation. I will never find relaxation. Relaxation as it is relaxation. Relaxation doesn't need to be found. I will never find being. I will never find being. Being as it is being. Being doesn't need to ever be found. Being doesn't need to ever be found. Being as it is being. Truth doesn't need to find itself. All right? Purity doesn't need to find itself. Love doesn't need to find itself. Nowness doesn't need to find itself. I will never find nowness. I will never find nowness. Nowness as it is nowness. Nowness doesn't need to ever be found. I will never discover radiance. Radiance as it is radiance. Radiance doesn't need to ever be found. I don't need to realize. I will never realize awake mind. Awake mind as it is awake mind. Awake mind never needs to be realized. I will never realize the totality. I will never realize the totality. The totality as it is the totality. The totality never needs to be realized. Never needs to be realized. I will never realize the Supreme. I will never realize the Supreme. The Supreme as it is the Supreme. The Supreme never needs to be realized. I will never discover awareness. I will never discover awareness. Awareness as it is awareness. Awareness doesn't need to be discovered. I will never realize the changeless. The changeless, as it is the changeless. The changeless doesn't need to be realized. I will never come upon illumination. Illumination as it is illumination. Illumination doesn't need to be found. I will never realize the all good. The all good as it is the all good. The all good doesn't need to be realized. I will never find the immutable. The immutable as it is the immutable. The immutable doesn't need to be found. I will never discover the ultimate. The ultimate, as it is the ultimate. The ultimate doesn't need to be discovered. Now, we're just doing these exercises and stretching. It's like stretching. We may not get this resonance. I'm not getting this big resonance yet. That's fine. This is preliminary. This is stretching. We're stretching. We're stretching. We're getting used to it. This is how it starts out. First, discursively, we introduce the exercise. Then we practice a little and then a little more. And we're just stretching and warming up. Just warming up. That's fine. Or if you get this resonance, that's fine too. It can happen at any moment. I will never find the traceless, uncontrived, spaced out, unborn, non-crystallizing, wide open, pure spaciousness of now. I will never find it. But the traceless, spaced out, wide open, pure spaciousness of now is the intrinsic, traceless, baseless, spaced out, wide open. It is that. The intrinsic, authentic, spaced out,
wide open pure spaciousness of now doesn't need to be found. Doesn't need to be found. So we're widening out the exercise a little bit, stretching a little more here. The immutable, I will never find the immutable, ultimate, total, all good, supremely authentic, as it is, non-localized, non-related, all good, miraculous, changeless core. I will never find it. But the immutable, ultimate, total, groundless, formless, all good, supreme, authentic, still, divine, seamless core, as it is the beautiful, transparent, changeless, all-pervasive, non-crystallizing, non-concretized, singular, process-free, natural, wide-open core. The effulgent, changeless, unalloyed, infallible, authentic, great perfection, beauty, beautiful, glorious, boundless, seamless, supreme core doesn't need to be found. I will never find the all-inclusive, empowering, intuitive, generous, surrendered, radiant, nurturing, forgiving, collaborative, loving, caring, sharing, natural, spaced out, all good, supreme, non-crystallizing, immaculate, non-localized, non-relative, formless, empowered, beautiful, glorious, core treasure of the one spaced out, all-pervasive, inclusive sweetness, incorruptible radiance of isness. I will never discover that. But the all-free, effulgent, unborn, core, formless, all-good, great perfection of the sharing, caring, intuitive, empowered, forgiving, all-healing, empathetic, humble, nurturing, radiant, surrendered, authentic, illumined, completely spaced out, transparent, traceless, groundless, baseless, all-sweet isness doesn't need to be found. Doesn't need to be found. I will never find the peaceful, blissful, calm, tranquil, still, serene, divine, pure, lovely, relaxed, wide open, spacious, abstract, miraculous, effulgent, immutable, total, ultimate, supreme being. But the great, compassionate, radiant, caring, loving, unalloyed, simple, lovely, all good, unborn, unceasing, changeless, locationless, locationless, non-fabricated, non-arranged, non-compounded, faceless, effulgent, fresh, relaxed, light of being. is that being. And that intrinsic, traceless, equal, inseparable, wide open, spaced out, transparent, core, unborn, simple, sure, illumined, self-aware, all smoothed out being does not need to be found. Does not need to be discovered. Does not need to be recognized. Does not need to be acknowledged. Does not need to be seen. Does not need to be identified. What is, is. What is, is. Is. What is doesn't need to be identified. Identity doesn't need to be identified. All right? Purity doesn't need to be identified. Being doesn't need to be identified. The absolute doesn't need to be identified. Nowness doesn't need to be identified. Timelessness doesn't need to be identified. Timelessness is timelessness. Timelessness doesn't need to be identified. Timelessness doesn't need to be identified, recognized, acknowledged, seen, discovered, found. Freedom doesn't need to be found. Freedom is freedom. Freedom doesn't need to be found. Vision is vision. Vision doesn't need to be seen. Stillness is stillness. Stillness doesn't need to be identified. What is, is. What is, is. What is doesn't need to be acknowledged. Doesn't need to be acknowledged. Authenticity doesn't need to be acknowledged. Authenticity is authentic. The all good doesn't need to be acknowledged. The all good is the all good. The all good doesn't need to be acknowledged. I don't need to acknowledge the all good. The all good, just as it is the all good. The all good doesn't need to be acknowledged. The all pervasive, okay? I don't need to acknowledge the all pervasive. The all pervasive is the all pervasive. Just as it is the all pervasive. The all pervasive doesn't need to be acknowledged. I don't need to see totality. Totality as it is totality. Totality doesn't need to be seen. Totality doesn't need to be seen. I don't need to discover the traceless. The traceless as it is traceless. The traceless doesn't need to be discovered. Doesn't need to be found. Doesn't need to be identified. I don't need to identify the traceless. The traceless as it is the traceless. The traceless doesn't need to be identified. God doesn't need to be identified. I don't need to identify God. God is as it is God. God doesn't need to be identified. We can say, I can't identify God. We can start out that way. I can never identify God. God as it is God. God doesn't need to be identified. I can never find the transparency. I can never find transparency. Transparency as it is transparency. Transparency doesn't need to be found. So, these exercises, you see, there are three parts to it, right? Three step. First step leads to the second, leads to the third. It's all one practice with three steps. So the first step is, I will never find God, anything. If you just take that and isolate it, as the ego will try to do, separate it from the other two steps, then you'll freak out. So the ego immediately freaks out when it hears this, because it believes in separation, the ego. It doesn't believe in wholeness, okay, holiness. It doesn't believe in holiness. So it'll segment it and separate it out and lose the meaning of it. Remember, the ego values meaninglessness. So it will look at this and say, I can never find God. And say, that's meaningless, it's meaningless. No, it's segmenting, separating, in order to make the practice meaningless. That's what the ego does. So you must reject that. You must reject the ego's interpretation of this. And you say, no, it's a three-part thing. First, I take the stand, I will never find God. I will never find God. But that's part of the second, that God as it is God. Meaning, there's no possibility of anything else other than God. So there can't be an inside to God, and there can't be an outside to God. So what is inside free and outside free, how can that be discovered? It cannot be discovered. And then you say, God doesn't need to be discovered. There's no need for God to be discovered. So the fact that I can't find God doesn't matter, because there's no need for it. So it's the capacity to do the practice as a whole, that's how you are holy. That is how holy. That is what holiness is. That is what holiness is. Holiness is the realization that holiness doesn't need to be found. Holiness as it is holy, holiness. But we need, because of the continuity problem, we need to gently set the search down. So there is this transitional thing, and you cannot ask the ego's opinion about this practice, because then the wheels will come off. Then it really, you'll feel the wobbliness of it all, as the ego says that there's no meaning in that. See, it segments it out. Don't segment it out. Don't fragment it. Don't fragment it. Previous videos, we did the inside free, outside free practice. And so this sort of builds upon that. It's understood now that God as it is God. There is no inside to God. There is no outside to God. If there's an outside, there's an inside. As long as we believe there's an inside outsideness to reality, we will believe reality can be discovered. That something is discoverable. Something's findable. The outside is finding the inside. The inside is finding the outside. There's something to be found. Now, divinity is inside free, outside free. I can never discover the inside free, outside free God. The inside free, outside free God is, just as it is the inside free, outside free God. The inside free, outside free God doesn't need to be discovered. Doesn't need to be discovered. So first we say we can't do it, we start thinking, oh wow, I can't do this. Then we state the fact of reality, that it's impossible to do this. And then we state the fact, therefore, we don't need to do it. We don't need to do it. We don't need to do it. So the need, the feeling of I need to find God, gradually drops. I don't need to find God. God is not findable. God doesn't need to be found. There is no inside to God. There is no outside to God. There is no inside to smooth the smoothness, the pure smoothness. There is no outside to the pure smoothness. So there's nothing to be found. It doesn't need to be found. It is. Just as it is, it is. Just as it is, it is. And you can, as you go about your day, you can say, just as it is, it is. Just as it is, it is. Whatever you're doing, just as it is, it is. Just as it is, it is. Now, it can refer to anything. Now, when you're busy in your life in the day, you might have a hard time identifying stuff and doing more formal practice. But you can say, just as it is, it is. doesn't need to be found. It doesn't need to be found. Just as it is. It doesn't need to be found. This is a shortened version of it for your, as you go about your busy day or non-busy day. Mine, I have a non-busy day. Don't have any work. Yeah, and that's a non-busy day. But I am doing the work right here, right? So just as it is. It doesn't need to be found. Just as it is. As you're walking down the street, as you're working at your store, maybe you're working in a store, and then you're doing stuff, and your cashier or whatever you're doing, you just say, just as it is, it is. Just as it is, it is. It doesn't need to be found. Just as it is, it doesn't need to be discovered. Just as it is, it doesn't need to be acknowledged. Just as it is, it doesn't need to be identified. Just as it is, it doesn't need to be found. It doesn't need to be found. Just as it is, it doesn't need to be found. This is the shorthand version. As you're riding your bike, maybe, you say, you're seeing everything going along. Just as it is, notice a tree. Ah, just as it is, it doesn't need to be found. On the road, just as it is, this road, just as it is, just as it is, it doesn't need to be found. And don't expect some enlightenment to come kaboom. Enlightenment never comes kaboom anyway. It's a gentle, it's a soft landing. It's a gentle, soft landing. There is no kaboom, so don't be looking for any kaboom. It's always a soft, soft landing. It's a soft landing into the vision of oneness. Into what doesn't need to be found. You see everything, none of this needs to be found. None of it needs to be identified. None of this needs to be acknowledged. Nothing needs to be acknowledged. Just think of that. Just think of the weight that takes off your mind. Nothing needs to be acknowledged. Nothing needs to be found. Nothing needs to be identified. Nothing needs to be named. Nothing needs to be named. I will never find the name of God. The name of God, as it is the name of God. The name of God doesn't need to be found. The name of God doesn't need to be found. Then the one name, actually God is nameless, ultimately. But in the vision of oneness, because we need to remember God, the nameless, God gives one name to everything. Okay, one identity to everything, every awareness, every location, everything we see is just the one name. I don't need to find the one name. I don't need to find the one name of God. Okay. I don't need to find it. I don't need to name anything. It's already named. I don't need to find everything. Everything's already found. I don't need to identify anything. Everything is already identified. So it takes this tremendous weight of thinking we need to identify, locate, name, arrange. I don't need to arrange anything. Everything's already arranged. I don't need to make anything perfect. Everything's already perfect. I don't need to find anything. Everything's already found. I don't need to find anything. Everything is already found. This as it is. This is as it is. This is as it is. It doesn't need to be found. This is as it is. It doesn't need to be named. This is as it is. This is as it is. It doesn't need to be located. This is as it is. It doesn't need to be discovered. This is as it is. It doesn't need to be identified. This is as it is. It doesn't need to be named. This is as it is. It doesn't need to be named. Will take off of us. Just think of the weight that this will take off of us. This is as it is. This doesn't need to be named. It is as it is. It doesn't need to be named. That's even shorter. It is as it is. It doesn't need to be located. It is as it is. It doesn't need to be found. It is as it is. It doesn't need to be identified. Or you can say, this is as it is. Or that is as that is. That is as that is. That doesn't need to be named. That tree is as it is. That tree is that tree. That tree as it is that tree. That tree doesn't need to be named. This day as it is this day. This day doesn't need to be named. This moment as it is this moment. This moment doesn't need to be named. It is as it is. It doesn't need to be named. It is as it is. It doesn't need to be named. This is the shorthand, the super shorthand. You can go back to this under any circle you're driving. It is as it is. It doesn't need to be named. It is as it is. It doesn't need to be found. It's already found. It's already found. Everything is already everything. Everything is already everything. Everything is already found. Everything is already discovered. I don't need to discover anything. Everything is already discovered. Everything already is named. Everything is already identified. Everything already is. It is as it 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 is. It doesn't need to be named. It is as it is. It doesn't need to be found. It is as it is. It doesn't need to be discovered. It is as it is. It doesn't need to be searched for. It is as it is. It doesn't need to be searched for. It is as it is. It doesn't need to be named. It is as it is. It doesn't need to be identified. This is getting to it. Thank you, Holy Spirit, inner teacher, for galvanizing this practice and so it can be shared with the entire planet, which it is. It's available to everyone on the planet, actually. So again, 1 in 100 will actually try practicing. Be that 1 in 100. Why not? You don't need to find yourself, you're already found. You don't need to find someone else. Everyone is already found. You just need to reinforce this fact. Everything is already identified. Truth is already true. You just need to reinforce this fact. You don't need to make it true. I don't need to make truth true. Truth as it is already true. Nothing needs to make truth true. Truth is already true. Truth doesn't need to be made true. So be the 1 in 100. Be the true 1%er. Okay. How do you escape the designs of the 1%ers in the world? And you know they do have designs. How do you escape that? By being the spiritual 1%er. Be the spiritual 1%er. Be the true 1%er. So I am the true 1%er. I'm actually practicing. I am the true authentic 1%er. I am the authentic 1%er. I am the intrinsic 1%er. I am the traceless 1%er. I am the residue-free 1%er. I am the immutable, all equal, effulgent, non-concretized, ultimate, core, unborn, authentic 1%er. I am that. 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 I am the authentic, core, true, residue-free, wide-open, non-crystallized, spaced-out, authentic, non-localized 1%er. I am that. I am that. Own it. Own it. Own it. See, I am that. practice, and then you say, I am there. I am the authentic one, because I'm practicing authenticity. I am that. That's the true one percenter. 1% of those who claim to be religious, spiritual, on the path, 1% will actually practice. The 99% won't. They won't. And they'll still be wobbling on the bicycle trying to keep it going. Yeah, they would. That's a fact. 1%. So be that 1%. Be the 1%er. Be the authentic 1%er. Own it. You got to step into it and own it. And it's fun. Just gather your will and do it. Gather your will and do it. It is as it is. It doesn't need to be named. It is as it is. It can start that way. It is as it is. It doesn't need to be named. It's the will and the courage to be the one percenter. Okay? That you start doing it. The authentic one percenter. The authentic. Now, of course, the others won't like you. That is true. The ones who say, no, I gotta find God, I gotta find God. You know, I need to find God. They won't like you. They say you're crazy, or they won't like it. Okay? Just like the world hates the one percenter, the rich, greedy one percenters, you know, that don't like them. Well, on the flip side, the authentic, spiritual one percenters, the religious people in the world and the others, the 99%, who are not authentic religious, authentic spiritual, not doing authentic prayer, authentic practice, authentic sadhana, authentic satsang, all that. They won't like it. They say, they want it all for themselves or something, you know, some rationalization, justification like that. But don't pay any attention to that. Don't pay any attention to that. Be authentic. You have the right to be authentic. Your will is not bound by 99%. It's not bound by anything. Your will is not bound. You have the right to be authentic. You have the right to be authentic. You have the right to be immaculate. You have the right to be pure. You have the right to be clear. You have the right to be peaceful. You have the right to be blissful. So you have the right to be authentic. Only the authentic are blissful. Only the authentic. And authenticity comes through practice. You have to practice the authenticity that you already are. Otherwise, you'll keep trying to find it. Don't try to find it, practice it. There's a difference. Because the practicing of it is saying, it can't be found, I don't need to find it. You have to practice that. Why? Because of the continuity issue. So don't let the ego trap you into saying that, you don't need to practice it, that's contradictory, blah, blah, blah. No, it's not, because we have a continuity problem. So we do need to use words, concepts, and practice. We do need to practice. We need to practice reminding ourselves we don't need to practice. Okay? That's the paradox, right? It's not a paradox when you realize we have a continuity problem. I need to practice realizing that I don't need to practice. Exactly. 99% won't get that. 1% will get that. I need to practice reminding myself that I don't need to practice. I need to practice reminding myself that I'm already authentic. And the ego says, well, if you're already authentic, what do you need to practice for? Because of the continuity problem, that's why you need to practice. So take that to the bank. Take it to the bank and be an authentic one percenter. And realize, I have a severe continuity problem. I do need to practice. And that the ego tells me that if I'm authentic, I don't need to practice it. I shouldn't need to practice it. That's a lie. Because I have this continuity problem. So 99% will believe the ego and say, oh yeah, the ego's right. If I'm authentic, I should need to practice. All I need to do is find it. No, I can't find it. But I need to practice realizing that I don't need to practice. I need to practice realizing and accepting that I don't need to practice. I need to practice acceptance that I don't need to practice. And that takes a lot of practice. So you see, when you plug in the continuity problem, all this paradox that the ego has been delaying you on, poof, you know, evaporates. It evaporates. It evaporates. And this is what holds every 99% back, is that it thinks it's an ego. It's contradictory. Wait a minute, they said you don't need to practice, you're already authentic. Well, if you're already authentic, you shouldn't need to practice that you're already authentic. That's crazy. If you plug in the continuity problem, it's no longer crazy. It's the ego that's crazy, you see. Because you have this severe continuity problem, and you'll never get it unless you deal with this continuity problem, which requires practice. It is as it is. It as it is as it is. It is as it is. It is as it is. It doesn't need to be discovered. It doesn't need to be practiced. It is as it is. It doesn't need to be practiced. So we're practicing acceptance that we don't need to practice. And if you can get that, you are the one percenter. If you can get that, if you can just accept it and say, I get it. I have a severe continuity problem. I need to practice that I don't need to practice. It is as it is. It doesn't need practice. God is, God as it is God. God doesn't need practice. Okay. But we need to practice that we don't need to practice. We need to practice getting it that we don't need to practice. And that is the practice. I need to practice that I don't need getting it that I don't need to practice. And that is my practice. So I truly hope that there's some out there in the world, whoever it is, doesn't matter who it is to me, whatever, whoever, who can get this, who can get this, say, I have a severe continuity problem. It's the only problem I have. I need to practice acceptance that I don't need to practice. And I really need to practice that because I have a very severe continuity problem. So I need to practice all the time. It is as it is. As you're going by the world and you go out your day, it is as it is. It doesn't need practice. It doesn't need to be found. It is as it is. It doesn't need to be located. It is as it is. It doesn't need to be located. It is as it is. It doesn't need to be practiced. It is as it is. It doesn't need to be labeled. It is as it is. It doesn't need to be found. It is as it is. It doesn't need to be discovered. It is as it is. It doesn't need to be categorized. It is as it is. It is as it is. It doesn't need to be found. It is as it is. It doesn't need to be practiced. It is as it is. It doesn't need to be named. And that is it. And that is it for this video.